When it comes to electric vehicles, we're making significant progress. Rolls-Royce recently unveiled an electric plane that it claims to be the fastest in the world, but did you know that we've also created and operated a fully electric cargo ship? That's right, the electric ship has been making waves since its debut. Welcome to our channel, Tech Region, and in this video, we'll see all you need to know about the Norwegian Yara Birkeland. The Norwegian Yara Birkeland is the world's first zero-emission cargo ship. This cargo ship will be a game changer in the fight against global warming. Ocean freight currently emits approximately a billion tons of CO2 per year. This is more than the world's five largest countries. According to a research report, if only half of the ocean traffic can be electrified, the world would be able to breathe a little easier. Yara Birkeland is a joint venture between Yara International, Norway's largest fertilizer company, and Kongsberg Group, an engineering firm specializing in civilian and military guidance systems. In February 2020, the hull was launched from Romania's Yard Brailer shipyard and shipped to Norway's Vard Brevik shipyard to be outfitted with her futuristic innards. To be clear, this is not the first autonomous ship to be launched. That honor belongs to Finland's Car Ferry, which debuted in 2018. Yara Birkeland, on the other hand, is a zero-emissions cargo ship, and the power to power her massive 7-megawatt-hour battery is supplied by the Swiss technology firm Leclanche and will be piped in from the Norwegian grid, which gets the majority of its energy from clean hydroelectric plants. On the other hand, the ship's onboard battery has 1,000 times the capacity of a domestic electric vehicle. What kind of cargo is this ship transporting? The ship carries just over 100 containers, which doesn't seem like much. The world's largest cargo ship can carry up to 24,000 containers at speeds of up to 20 knots. This is twice the speed of the Yara Birkeland. But here's the thing, Yara Birkeland is a fantastic concept that has gotten off to a great start. The vessel has been commissioned by Yara International to transport raw materials and finished fertilizers between three ports in southern Norway, Henria, Brevik, and Larvik. According to the company, moving this freight by road currently necessitates 40,000 fully loaded truck journeys per year. The Yara Birkeland will eliminate all emissions and tiresome refueling stops in one fell swoop. As a result, local roads will be quieter and safer for Norwegians. At the moment, the maximum voyage length between Henria and Larvik is only about 30 nautical miles. The ship will be powered by two rotatable azopulpool pods, each producing 900 kilowatts, and two electric tunnel thrusters, each producing 700 kilowatts. The Yara Birkeland can sense what's around it on Norway's busy waterways thanks to a complex suite of radar, LiDAR, nautical AIS, that's automatic identification system, regular cameras, and night vision infrared cameras. The ship will never venture more than 12 nautical miles from the coast. If necessary, only three separate operational hubs will be available to deal with any crisis and provide periodic surveillance. Experts in the maritime industry generally agree that autonomous ocean-going vessels are perfectly feasible with current technology, but the issues that could arise if a fault occurred far out at sea could prohibitively be expensive, not to mention unacceptably dangerous for the time being. Yara Birkeland had hoped to launch the ship last year, but the pandemic pushed the date back a few months. The ultimate goal is to make not only sailing, but also loading and unloading at each port self-sufficient. For the time being, this is still on the drawing board and will be handled by human-operated cranes. The regulatory oversight framework required for such difficult maneuvering in all weather conditions is evolving. So, will all container ships be self-driving and electric in the near future? It's difficult to say right now. If the Yara Birkeland is a success, when it finally ditches all of its safety crew, which is expected to be by the end of 2022, other companies will similarly be limited. Nearshore use cases will be interested in the technology. If we do decide to have autonomous cargo transport navigating busy, larger international ports with their own complex legal and regulatory ecosystems will be the greater challenge. However, Yara Birkeland is currently setting a record by slashing Yara International's operating costs by a whopping 90%. This is despite the ship's estimated cost of $25 million. In comparison, a standard container ship of the size is much cheaper, three times cheaper to be exact. And with that being said, it's time to end our video. What are your thoughts about seafare and cargo freight? Let us know in the comment section below. And with that being said, thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.